Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I'm the host and the visionary of the Valder Beebe Show's God Talk. Some people talk to God and others believe that God talks to them. Join us in conversation with authors, religious clergy, metaphysicians, and regular people like you and I and God Talk. God Talk is a podcast available on FM radio, Roku TV, and online. Subscribe at valderbeebeshow.com. You can also subscribe at youtube.com/valderbeebeshow. Join the conversation of God Talk. I'll see you there.
Good day and welcome back to the Valder Beebe Show. I've had a fabulous morning, but you know, I have the best guests. I have people who have something to say. My next guest is Liz DeBold Fusco. She's with Airbnb and she always has something to say. Liz, welcome back to the Valder Beebe Show.
Thanks so much for having me again.
You know, sadly, summer is winding down. But, you know, let's take a look back and see how Americans spent their summers traveling. What do you guys know at Airbnb? Because you guys monitor travel a lot.
Yeah, you know, when we kicked off this summer, we shared how after a year of isolation, we thought consumers were really eager to begin traveling again. And, you know, we saw this summer, consumers did start traveling again. They hit the road again, largely to spend some quality time with their loved ones. You know, we saw families that were flocking to remote destinations from big cities, and we saw people who were planning trips near national and state parks. And actually, a few weeks ago, Airbnb reached our biggest night ever in the US with more than 4 million guests staying on Airbnb. And this has created a lot of opportunity for hosts this summer. US hosts on Airbnb collectively earned this summer more than $1.3 billion, whether it was by hosting while they were away to pay for their vacation, or maybe creating a really amazing treehouse or yurt to share a one-of-a-kind stay. This demand is actually, it's one of the reasons why we kicked off this season by launching a brand new host onboarding process. We've actually made it easier than ever before to become a host, and hoping that people would be able to take advantage of the opportunity this summer and now heading into fall.
I'm meeting people who say that they heard you guys on my show and they're considering or they have become a host. So you guys are doing a good job.
Oh, we love to hear that. That's amazing. I mean, you know, and it makes sense, right? Because I'll actually note that, you know, here in Texas, we've actually seen new hosts have been able to really tap into this opportunity. Texas actually is one of our top 10 most profitable areas for new Airbnb hosts in the US. Actually, new hosts in Houston earned $3.3 million in the first half of the year. So again, now is the time to consider hosting, especially as we head into the fall and we know people are going to continue to travel.
That's right. So tell me about the fall trends. We talked a little about summer. What do you guys foresee for the fall?
Yeah. So summer's winding down, season's beginning to change for better or for worse. And we are seeing a couple of trends. So first trend worth calling out is longer stays. Longer stays are trending in part due to the fact that remote working is continuing into the fall, which is allowing people to extend their vacation. Actually, heading into Labor Day weekend, a large share of trips are 7 nights or longer as people take advantage of the holiday, the extra day off to maybe get in one last vacation before the kids go back to school or you go back to work. The other trend that we're seeing is that after largely going to rural destinations over the summer, we're seeing that searches for stays among guests in large and mid-sized cities make up about a third of searches for each for fall. So people are starting to head back to urban areas, maybe as a way to enjoy some lovely fall activities like leaf peeping or apple picking or going to a pumpkin patch or just some of those other traditions that people have really missed over the past year and a half.
That brings my next question. So will we see a return of these big events and fall travel? Will that be impacted?
Yes, absolutely. So we know big events are coming back and we know guests seem to be really excited to attend them. Actually, a lot of our top trending destinations for fall are places that are good, our cities specifically, that are going to be hosting either sporting events or major music festivals. A couple that come to mind are the Made in America Festival or Astroworld in Houston, or even the Ryder Cup in Wisconsin. All of these events have inspired an increase in searches for accommodations in the area that will be welcoming the events. And, you know, that is, again, great news for hosts in these areas who can earn money by sharing their home with that influx of guests, as well as for local economies, especially post-pandemic. This means that there'll be guests heading to restaurants and to local shops and spending money there, and again, helping to drive the economic recovery.
I want my audience to know that Liz DeBolt-Foucault is the communications lead for North America for Airbnb. So your information comes direct from the source. Liz, where can my audience go and find out more information, especially those who say they want to become hosts?
Yes. So if you want to become a host, maybe you know a big event that's coming to your area. Maybe you think you are living in a fall destination that people are going to want to head to this fall. You can go to airbnb.com/host. It's a great place to get started as a host. There's a lot of great resources there. Again, go to airbnb.com/host.
I thank you so very much. And thanks for the great information. I look forward to your next conversation.
Thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of your day.
Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I host the Valder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television. And this is my phone pouch. My phone pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com.